Good afternoon. An advocacy group in New Mexico is hitting the streets hoping to help anyone whose child has gone missing. The two founders are mothers who know what it's like to have a runaway. News 13's Brianna Gallegos is live in the Newsplex with the story.
Kim, oftentimes we see pictures of missing children on social media and parents asking for help. Now a nonprofit group in Belen is trying to help parents reunite with their kids.
Well, a couple of years ago it started. My son went missing.
In 2013, Shonda Murillo's son ran away twice. He was missing for 2 weeks at a time.
I went out and actually put flyers up. I asked people. I even put a reward up for him. I would call the cops every time I saw him because they told me not to address my son.
Worried sick, Shonda understands the fear and anxiety parents experience when they can't find their child.
There's hardly anything here in Valencia County that helps kids or helps, you know, the parents. And a lot of the parents that I've talked to in the past have told me there's no support.
That's why Shonda teamed up with Nadine Osborne. Together, they formed a nonprofit group to help families of missing kids. Valencia County Missing Children started in February of this year.
We ask, you know, how can we help, even if it's just driving around looking or following leads. We will never confront anybody.
Together, the two moms are determined to find every missing child, starting in Valencia County, runaway or Amber Alert. But that's not all. They do more than reunite missing kids with their parents.
If they need help with counseling or whatever, we can give them those referrals for that.
They say they work close with Belen Police Department. Since Belen is a small city, they say the department is small and it has a lot on its plate.
Law enforcement does as much as they possibly can and humanly possible.
But at the end of the day, the goal is to change a missing sign to found.
Valencia County Missing Children also works with Valencia County Sheriff's Department, but they do make sure that parents file a police report first. Kim, back to you.
Okay, thanks, Brianna. Now the group welcomes volunteers, but they do have to pass a background check.